What's up there, butterfly and moth fans? It's me, your sexy moth king, Bart Cobbins. Today I'm going to show you one of my favorite butterflies called the Indian oak leaf butterfly. Its name, the oak leaf, well, it's not that far-fetched considering the butterfly, when it's resting, looks exactly like a leaf. This is one of those butterflies that have simply amazing and breathtaking camouflage. This butterfly is found in India, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh and Myanmar, and is also found in China, Thailand, Laos, Taiwan, Vietnam and basically many parts of India as well that I didn't mention. The habitat of this butterfly is reportedly thickly forested lowlands, but they can also occur higher up in the hills, up to 2500 meters as far as I know. Now, I mainly study moths and not butterflies, so take what I say with a grain of salt, but this is my intel, my information. And this butterfly during the day spends most of its time sitting still, usually on the floor between leaf litter, where it's accidentally camouflaged between fallen leaves. But they are also commonly found on tree barks, sitting on the trunks of trees, usually face downward, facing the floor. A single disturbance usually sends them flying away. Now, what's interesting is, as camouflaged as this species is, when it opens its wings, it reveals a world of color. And the iridescent blue and orange stripes on these forewings make this butterfly an amazing beauty. Reportedly, it's a polyphagous butterfly. And here I have a list of some of the of the plants that the caterpillars have been reported eating. One of them is Ruellia, but I also see Prunus persica mentioned, Polygonum orientale, Giardinia diversifolia, and Strobilantis species. Now, the Strobilantis species, they seem to be particularly fond of, because there's multiple species on my list, including Strobilantis flaccidifolius, Glandiluferia, and Tashiroi. They will also eat Hygrophila salicifolia, Lepidagrattis formosensis, and I know these plants all sound very complicated, but most of them don't have a common name. Last but not least, I'm also not really someone that studies plants intensively, so you'll have to take my word for it, and if you want a scientific name, you can always ask me in the comments to write it down. But their food plants are mainly in the Acanthaceae, Rosaceae en Urticaceae families.
Lichtgevende dieren. Ik ga lichtgevende algen kweken in een potje. Voor video. En ik heb ook allemaal...
Now, what is very interesting is that reportedly this butterfly has two forms. A wet season form and a dry season form. And they quite differ in size, but also in color pattern. And as far as I know, these butterflies are quite rarely recorded at flowers, I think never actually. So I think that they are fructivorous. A common feeding strategy, especially among forest species, is to feed from fallen fruits and drink the sweet juices from the fermenting, rotting fruits, which are full of sugars, which may be an alternative way of feeding yourself instead of visiting flowers. It's actually quite common among some butterfly groups. For example, morpho butterflies or apatura butterflies, the purple emperors. They also never visit flowers and they all prefer to find sweet excretions from fruits. So, thank you for watching. This was a short video with some fun facts, just showing off another species really. Like and subscribe if you like this video. I got some really cool projects coming up in the future. Thanks and goodbye.